explained to 60 Minutes anchor Scott Pelley that there would be a second wave of the U.S. mortgage crisis, but nevertheless, the stock market would soar. Soon after, stocks started the biggest bull market run in U.S. history. Then, in March 2015, Tilson appeared again on 60 Minutes, this time with Anderson Cooper, and revealed a huge scandal at one of America's largest home improvement companies, Lumber Liquidators. Soon after, the company's stock price fell nearly 80%. And that brings us to today. Whitney Tilson, one of the most famous former hedge fund managers in America, who's appeared twice on national television to explain major financial news stories, is stepping forward again. But this time, he's not waiting for 60 Minutes. Instead, he's revealing the full story here first. Tilson has met with President Clinton and Obama, attended Warren Buffett's last 21 Berkshire Hathaway meetings, and spoken at the country's most prestigious business schools such as Harvard, Columbia, and Wharton. And today, he's going public with details on what he calls the biggest economic and financial story in America that almost no one is talking about. Tilson says the recent convergence of two incredible new technologies will soon dramatically change the value of homes and real estate all over the country. Put as much as $6,000 a year back into most U.S. families' bank accounts. Force the radical overhaul of the tax code in almost every city and small town in America. Transform the energy business, the insurance industry, and parts of the healthcare industry. All while saving millions of lives and making early investors a potential fortune. Why should you pay attention to Whitney Tilson's latest big prediction? For one simple reason. He has one of the best track records in America when it comes to pinpointing the most profitable stock market moves. Consider, he called the exact day Bitcoin would peak in value and the exact hour marijuana stocks would start their big collapse. More recently, just after the stock market bottomed during the coronavirus crisis, Tilson said, "This is the absolute best time to be an investor in more than a decade." He was exactly right. Stocks had the best quarter in more than 20 years. There's probably not another financial analyst in the world who can make these claims. Tilson has also accurately predicted the decline of 88 different stocks, including three bankruptcies. He even helped oust the CEO of America's most famous rental car company, which filed for bankruptcy earlier this year. And along the way, Tilson also purchased for his clients many of the most valuable stocks in recent history, long before they were household names, including Netflix when it was $7.78 a share, Apple at $1.42 per share, and Amazon at $48 a share. This is why CNBC once nicknamed Whitney Tilson the prophet, and why it's critical for you to take a few minutes to hear about the huge new trend Tilson has identified. Today, the convergence of two brand new technologies have hit a tipping point, and as a result, a new technological development has started to roll out in California, Arizona, Massachusetts, Pennsylvania, Texas, Florida, and Washington, D.C. And despite the coronavirus,
sorry about that 50-minute ad that started to play there, and also the sound, the video sound that I kept running on accident. Welcome to the stream. My name is Sven. Some people I go by Steve in some places because that's my government name, and I am here tonight playing Sable. It's going to be the Well, I played the demo of this game. So we're gonna give this a try. Let me just, oops, I forgot something again. Let me just make sure I can see my chat. There we go. Anyway, yeah, so I'm playing tonight in support of St. Baldrick's Childhood Cancer Research Foundation. They're a group that funds children's cancer research all over the world. And I'm supporting them via Tiltify. So if you see on the other side of the screen over there, there's a little QR code. You can go ahead and scan that if you'd like to make a donation to Childhood Cancer Research. You can also go, if you're on Twitch, you can go below this video and click over to the About Me section. And there's a couple of links in there. There'll be one that goes to St. Baldrick's and one that goes to my Extra Life campaign. We're not talking about Extra Life tonight, though. Tonight is all about St. B's. For those of you who are maybe more familiar with a more famous cancer research organization, St. B's is a little bit different in that they fund lots of different projects all over the world, as opposed to just the ones that take place in one specific spot. So it's a little bit different. Now we're getting into the game, so I'm gonna shut up and play a little bit. It's also like my first time streaming to Twitch and YouTube at the same time, so if I miss a comment, I apologize. Controls, even though I've got a gamepad, which is fun. So just a face over here. Seems a little choppy, just so you know, that's like an animation style thing that's happening. That's not necessarily my stream, although it could be. Let me just point towards the wall, okay. Oh, and you can climb on this stuff too. There's a stamina bar. Ladders don't take stamina, but like other vertical surfaces do. Jotty smiling behind her mask, just as I know she can feel the teeth-baring little grimace behind me, behind mine. I'm nervous and she's softly, sweetly amused. In her eyes, I probably have very little to worry about. Jotty, you know you have nothing to worry about, don't you, Sable? And yet, I shrug, but any attempts to act casual or fruitless. The The movement is jerky, and I don't think I've ever been more aware of my little shoulders. She laughs. I mean it. But I don't know how you are. You're going to be nervous until you've started. Oh, but I do know how you are. You're going to be nervous until you've started, and then you'll act like you've been doing it your whole life. Remember the first time you rode a bike? You wouldn't even let me put you on the seat. You were so afraid. Your hands were like little claws gripping into me. I feel the memory in my fingers. But until then, I promised you I was going to be alright. I told you how much I had loved riding my bike as a young woman, and how wonderful the wind felt through fabric. Suddenly, there you were. You sat down, you learned to lean forward and put those little grasping claws on the handles, and you were off. And I remember thinking, just watching you tear over the sand. Look at her. She can do whatever she wants. Jenny reaches out and pats a hand on the edge of my mask. And you can, Sable. I take a breath. I think I'm ready. Nod. Ready? No, you are. So get started. You need to talk to Hillal and Driss. Driss should already have made the arrangements for your bike, and Hillal will share something. Well, let's say, as useful as it is fun, I think I might suspect what Jenny is saying, but I stay quiet. For that, I suppose we'll see you off. I'll be back soon. You know, planning a return before you even left. Take all the time you need. It's a big decision you're making. I tell her that I'm so eager to make it. Choose well and quickly. I don't know how far I'm going. Whatever you decide, you do so with my blessing, so don't try using me as an excuse to come home early. I go speak with Hillal. I see you off in the Driss as well, and ride your bike with Cizo, who. But you know how he is. Oh, we know how Cizo is. I have something to give you, a compass to help you on your journey. It's the same one I used on my gliding. An artifact, you might say. It's naturally there, perfectly weighted and crafted. Each component slides together with an incredible slant. Thank you. Go on. It's now time. So, left bumper. That's easy. I approach Hillal, they give me an enthusiastic wave. I always appreciate Hillal's nerve and vigor. And on a day like this, I'm ready to match it with a touch of nerves and balance. Sable, take this gliding stone. It's a small round stone. As it nestles into my palm, I feel a warmth. Not borrowed from Hillal's hands, but emanating from within. I run a thumb over it and find it softly electric, like static on cloth. Thank you. I thank them for the fuzzy rock. Oh, Sable, you don't know what this is, do you? I've just given you as a gliding stone. What do you feel? I tell Hillal that I feel fuzziness? Then you're doing it right. You feel in that stone is openness. I look at the stones, it seems quite closed. Gliding stones are vessels for the perpetual. Capital P, perpetual. They suck up power like little sponges and hold it there for you to channel. Right now it's empty or dormant and waiting for you to fill it up. I ask how I can do this. Take it to the temple ruins at the edge of the canyon. You'll be able to activate it there. Okay. I'll catch your hand twice and bobs a little. I appreciate their good mood at a time like this. Come back to me once it's done. I want to hear all about it. About to leave, Hillal stops me. Oh, you haven't gotten to your bike yet, have you? It's a bit of a trek out of the temple, so go see Driss. He wanted to meet you to get that ready for you. Remember Jal's words, and Hillal wanted to see Driss. Let's go see Mr. Driss. This post box logging in. Hello, Sable. 0 unread messages. Have a good day. Okay. Oops. Keep Here's the guy. I need myself not to be too eager. That's all I can do. Not to race up Chris. Chris is the camp manager. He's been difficult to get a hold of lately, but I know... But now I strongly suspect that he's been working on my bike in secret. Perhaps a little perhaps it's extra beautiful or has some custom feature. What will be its name, I wonder? How fast will it go? Will my legs feel sore, or will I get used to it? Let's turn to this for start. Sable, hello. It won't let me just say hello. Oh well. That's what you had something special for me. Something special? I nod meaningfully, but he doesn't seem to get the hint. I make a leading gesture, slowly trying to be perfectly cool and confidential. But I can't do it, I'm too keen. And the words spill out, I ask if Driss might sort of possibly maybe have a bike for me. Your bike? He yells as if it's like he just heard. Your bike? Yes, of course, right. Yes, your bike. That's, that I was meant to, that I prepared for you because today is your gliding, yes. There's not one, but yes, of course. Right, yes, yes, I don't have that. my blood runs cold. Has he forgotten? By which I mean I arranged it for you in a, well, it's sort of a tutorial for you. Did you forget? I'm telling you I didn't forget. I just made different arrangements. You see, Sable, before one can own their own bike, they need, they must prove that they can ride a bike by taking a test ride on a different bike. Think about it, and I've never heard that part of the gliding, but Driss does seem earnest, sort of. So instead of worrying about your bike, I'd like to try this bike as a test. Driss just sand cutter aside. It's quite old and a little shabby. A tester if ever I've seen one. What's the bike's name? That's a bit personal, don't you think? Just sand cutter will do for now. Youngsters these days, always asking questions. Now ride that thing through the ring and back. Here's some advice for you, my young glider. Don't fall off. Alright. Okay. So, I'm gonna switch to ring. Okay, so strafing just to... Oh, strafing switch is like a mode switch. It has some... Somehow managed to seem caught off guard despite knowing I was coming. Congratulations, it was your first pre-glide ride. Any strange rattles, unexpected hissing, small fires? What do you mean fires? Surely you'd notice if you were on fire even a little bit. Yes, absolutely. Well, obviously that didn't happen, so I think we're fine. Is this bike dangerous? Well, he doesn't finish. Have you already been by Halal? Oh, right. I've forgotten how I'll address him a reminder before at least nudging him a little about the bike. Ask him if I'll be still be getting one. Well, you're getting the use of the sand cutter. That's something, eh? You can borrow it to run your little errands. My little errands? And Halal's got something to show you, too. Help you out with more of that mobility you're after. My confidence in this exercise only lightly tarnished. I thank Driss very much for his help and his bike, and I depart from it. So, I now have... Alright, so that symbol is the bike. That's the map. Okay. There's the quest log. The ceremony, I can go talk to that guy. I will go do this one. Sable back. Here. Oh, I can just, okay. Might not make it, might not make it. Oh, I made it. Down. That's no good. It might be puzzle time. Where'd all the color go? That's weird. Some thrums like the beat of a heart as I approach the altar. It feels right. I'm ready for Rohana to know me. I'm ready to know myself. Feel her curiosity in the sacred place. I know I am in her sight. So I go A to glide in midair, okay. I see, this is like a jumping puzzle. Looks like I can make it to that middle rock there. Looks like it's gonna fall apart to me. Jump, glide. There we go. I'm like down here to pick up. I'm guessing it would stand out. Okay, I'm gonna get. Yay! Oh dang, it's getting dark already. Thank you. Oop. Careful. Gently. Okay. Hop up here, and then hop up here. Climb this. And here's the man. Return to hall. It's clear they know what I've just experienced. They're excited on my behalf in a way that makes me miss them before I've even left. Isn't it incredible? How does it feel? Exciting. True freedom. All hovering is exciting. I ramble for a moment about all the things that I've been able to do when I'm out there in the world. Most of them involve me falling on my head and not getting hurt, but I'm sure I'll come up with more practice. Alright, you can do anything you want. Unless the moon doesn't darken, but the side of that out holds a bit of sorrow. You're very lucky, you know. I miss it so much, that feeling, just a floating breeze. But I suppose it's best that it fades with age, or else I might never have come back from my gliding. Just be out there heaving myself into chasms. I'll heave myself into chasms for you. Tell all that I'll throw myself into a thousand chasms and every half of a giggle. That's what I like to hear. I know people manage to keep it up, but I don't know that I've got the time to practice as much as they do. It takes serious focus. I'll laugh, even if there's a bit of regret in it. And I certainly haven't got that. Still, I suppose the gliding wouldn't mean much if it were all gains and no loss. Think about that, but decide there's already too much loss on my mind to consider it much further. I'm saying goodbye to my clan, my family, my home, my childhood. To lose the perpetual is a sacrifice for another time. You're gonna love it out there, Sable, even when you don't. Advice, try to have fun. There's a lot to be said about the ritual and independence and all of that out there, but the world's an easier place if you just put joy first. I thank you all for their service and for the help, and I tell them I'll miss them. It'll be over before you know it. Morning and receiving this room all one. Say goodbye to Halal. Before I go, Halal gestures towards the tower. It seems Caesar wishes to see me. Before I leave the clan. He still has. Section of obscure device historic ballads. It's a great verse. It's much about our folk buried in the sand. Okay. She's also an outclanner to the Ibex, but I've known her for nearly as long as I can recall. I think of her more as a kind of a distant relation than any sort of outsider. Machinists, I'm told, are given their posts, and by their training and their code, must go where they are needed. But Caesar has been among us for so long that Caesar forgets an assignment first and foremost. As far as any of us are concerned, she's one of us. I think there's a perpetual perception among the other clans that the Ibexi are quite insular, or that our designation of Ibexi versus outclanners suggests some nervous othering of those who are unlike us, but in practice, such things are more the result of our nomadic nature. We seek to know who will travel with us and who we must leave behind, but all are welcome to join. I'm always pleased to see what you did. What do you do, clan child? I can only think of one thing. Better now that I'm getting my bike. Let's say excited. She's like the third quality of their voice, and it rumbles through her mask when she laughs. She's quite a serious person most days, and I'm always torn between pride and alarm when I manage to make her chuckle. Yes, Jetty told me how excited you were. She's a sniffs. She also told me Driss would be coming along to get your bike together, but I think he may have... I knew it. Well, I hadn't meant to say it out loud, so I tell her I was just clearing my throat. I don't begrudge Driss for his forgetfulness. Were I tasked with so many odds and ends, I might be just as scattered. And besides, this will be good for you. I want you to scavenge the hover bike parts yourself. I didn't read what I said. Let him have the privilege of bonding with your bike before it's closed. No, this should be good for you. Here, take this. The navigator, she's gonna hand me something. This is a navigator. You can use it to mark waypoints on your compass. It should be useful for finding the old parts. This is when you're our bikes are reborn in ruined ships and fragments spare apart. A good start would be the ship down there near the camp. Find another in the Great Rock near the other side of the canyon. And another behind the old dam on the hill. Use your navigator to mark them down if you need. You'll need to gather a control panel, power supply, and a calibrator. Be back before you know it. Something new out of the old. So navigator is right bumper. This is a little bit clunky. Oh god. It's not going far. Face the thing I wanna and then do it. This way. Slowly. Oop, too far. Tones it makes. That's wrong button. To be found on the ship, but I noticed a blinking light flashing on the dashboard in the cockpit. Push the button. Voice crackles from the machinery in front of me. It sounds like a recording, fairly audible. Stop messing around with those buttons, you absolute idiot. Sorry, Raman. Concentrate, I don't think yet I have to remind you how much work was to get this far. We're almost there. Alright, let's see if that old machinist told us holds up. If not, there'll be hell to pay. Get cinematic mechanical adjustments being made, three clicks, buttons being pressed perhaps. Okay, push this orange thing, pull that lever hard. Yes, right. Clicking around, grunt before snapping. That hard, you've torn it out. Suddenly the speakers are filled with static and the low rumble gradually increases the pitch. Then the sound of someone cheering, it worked for flying. More cheering, it sounded that, and dancing. Okay, okay, let's focus. This thing's moving fast. We need to slow it down a bit. How do we do that? Let me check the machine's notes. Long pause, room ecstatic. Start playing when the shift's off. Still increasing your pitch. Ramen. That lever tone, the one you just ripped out. We're going too fast and we're going to crash. We need to try to. And then the brake comes off. Okay. Oh, so somebody broke the brakes on this button. Calibrator. I'm immediately on guard. Saima has always been a mischief maker and a tremendous pleasure and taken tremendous pleasure in tormenting me. In theory, I'm older, more experienced. Should be more able to withstand it in practice. You won't find it here. I've hidden it. You'll never find it. Never. Never. You're supposed to get to me. Give it back. Gliding, and she's a child. No, I don't think I will. That's also my intuition. I'm going to give her the satisfaction of crossbow and try to affect her. Give her the calibrator. Put my hand. Put out my hand, okay? If you give me some beetles, fair trade, isn't it? Something you want for something I want. Try to decide if it's more mature to push her over and steal a calibrator or to acquiesce. Then I simply stifle a sigh and shake the little hand. Perhaps some of the adults in camp know where I can find some. Alright. So. Ask about we're gonna find some beetles. There's a nest of beetles just east of here. You can't just walk up to one and catch it though. Some seeds growing on the rocks around the nest. Drop a seed on the floor and the beetle will start eating it. And then you can sneak up and grab it. A little glider. Some strange being called that. Yeah, clan child. They're trying to get used to it. Seems to really like it. Yeah, I like it too. Alright, so beetles are east of town. Let's see, north, south, west, east. Okay, so we'll go do this one next then. East of the camp. Okay, so where's my bike? Bike this way. Damn, that's easy. Okay. guessing this way. I'm getting like cricket noises, so I guess maybe there's beetles in here. Yep, there's beetles, all right. All right, so I crouch. So I don't want them all to run away. Oop, oop, oop. Dang it. Yeah, okay. Even if I'm crouching, I get close to him. I bet if I were running, they would all be running super far away from me. This way. Oh. So let's see, where are they? There's one there. Two there. There's one there. Three. Yay, I got beetles. Yay. Alright, so while we're out here, we'll just go do the dam. Move my bike so it's closer to the exit. Oh, there it is. Thank you. cylinder thing goes in that cylinder-shaped hole. Mark this one. Oh, it gives me a paper. Piercingly indicated as a hand saying to the Beatles, but rather than gloat, she hands me the calibrator and begins to cry. What have I done? You're leaving, and you'll never come back. Comfort. She blows her nose and then wipes her hand on her tunic. Yara never came back after the last gliding. Aren't you sad? You were her friend. She might come back. Plan, but how will you find us? We've moved a million times by then. I offer that we'll always find the Abexi no matter what. Please don't go. I will tell Sama not to worry. She goes back sooner than she knows, and I'm sure she pouts behind her mask. And I add that if I'm not back sooner than she knows, then she will be ready for her gliding, and then by then she can come and bother me herself. I promise. I say yes. How would I stop you from finding me? Goodbye for now. Okay. So, power supply time. so far. We're not quite up to where I got to in the beta. I pressed the frightening. So was that the tour size sandwich for stones? The ceremony, okay. Deliver the parts of the I kinda wanna see if the lit up wires go anywhere. It looks like they're just a marker so you can find it from far away. Oh, no, there's a chest. Look at that. Let's see, a cache of 100 cuts made from the metal harvested from crashed ships. They have holes punched in the middle of them where a rope can be slid through for easy and convenient transportation. Okay. I'm rich. Oop. When it saves... Okay. So whenever it auto-saves, sometimes it, gets a little choppy. So we're gonna have to run all the way around this. Just float forever. That's nice. Bouncy. Here we go. Who's your gliding like? Tell you when you get back? Okay, fine. Have all you want. recognize this. She loves her voice with a whisper. I did meet some crystal farmers once. Crystal farmers, and that's all I'll say about it. Okay. All right. What are you doing? What's your deal? So he looks across the landscape. Zeki's shoulders sag a little. I wonder what he's thinking about. Something in her mind. Zeki's voice is weak and incredulous. I don't know how she's done it. That's Illyria over there. Following the ace roll speck in the distance, which I now understand is her daughter Illyria. You want me to get her back? Zeki shakes her head. No, she's fine. I'll get her. She shrugs. Parenting. I suppose I'll know more about that when I'm older. Okay. Here we go. Going up the stairs. Going up the stairs to get my bike. I think they're still up here. We shall find out. Oh, nope, no, it's just a chest. Just money. Oh, wait, no. There they are. Return to Shizo with the parts. And it's as she waves me over that I feel a pang of sadness in my chest. When will I see her again once I'm gone? Well done, Sable. Yes, this is everything we need. Are you ready to assemble a bike of your own? I'm ready. And let us head to the workshop. She's relaxed in the workshop. It isn't that she's particularly rigid or anxious or ordinary. A certain calm beauty. Appreciates when she's in her element. I wonder if this is a way for all machinists. You must understand, Sable, is that the components you acquired, they fit together, not by chance, not by effort, but by nature. They belong together. They have always belonged together. All we are doing is assembling her from what she has been. I nod, and I feel a soft buzzing in my ears. Among my clan, we believe that machines have names held for ages, like deep secrets unheard by those unequipped to listen. We will find this one's name together. All right. So let's see. What have we got? So one of them was a controller, one of them was like the... All right, well, this is the engine. This goes in first. This was like the connector, and this was like the control panel. So the control panel goes in. Right. And then this goes last. Tilt her head a moment, leaning closer to Simoon. All at once, I know the hover bike's name, Simoon. I say it in a whisper to let Shizo know. Simoon. Simoon. Well done, Sable. What sort of name is that? I ask Shizo what sort of name it is, and she speaks to any particular kind of culture. If it does, then I don't know it. Perhaps you will find it out on your journey. Shizo sucks. You'll see yourself, or perhaps you won't. I think it hardly matters. You're bonded all the same. Tells the moon that I'm eager to know her better. And Shizo looks quite proudly at both of us. You are ready then for your gliding. May all the gods turn their faces from you, Sable. An odd blessing, perhaps, but Shizo is prone to such things, and I can read in her tone that it's meant quite sweetly. You must learn to listen to Simoon. To care for her, seek out fellow machinists on your travels, Sable. They will teach you the art of machine whisper. take this. The machine is bad. She will meet plenty of my elk on your glidings. Know them. Show them you're worthy and give a good, we'll give you more badges. I thank you so twice for good measure and give a bow. I'm ready. I should speak to Jabi. Okay. So, now. Yeah, I gotta go up, right? Yes, it's a ladder. There we go. Jetty's the old lady in the middle. Here we go. Sable at Cartar Verlanda's Bloom on your way. You should speak to him, see if he can get a map. Why not be in to go, but Jetty gets right back and puts him in my hand. Money to get you going on your journey, use it most wisely. And then all wisely when the mood strikes, it's good to know you have to know the value of money, but you never want to be ruled by it. I think Jabi went effusively and headed out of my way. So, balloon. Balloon. Where am I going? Greetings, child. I saw you were looking longingly at my great balloon. Quite a piece of work, isn't she? It really is. You know, enthusiastically, it's really an impressive vessel. However nervous I get imagining being up there all alone. I wonder if anyone's ever fallen off one. Best not to ask right now. Well, good to meet you. And oh, I should introduce myself. I'm Jordan. Sable. I suppose if you come all this way to see me, probably a map you're after, Sable. I would love a map. I tell the photographer I would love a map. Of course you would. That'll be 50 cuts. I'll buy that map. Perfect. And let's trade. There we go. You might have a map. Your map. Possibility. Something about this makes me feel more real. On your gliding, Sable. I still remember mine. As it was. Sure, I knew since I was a boy that photography was for me. So I spent a little extra time out there just to enjoy the world. Speaking of, keep an eye on the skies. They have plenty of my colleagues out there. And they'll have more maps to sell you from Koa to the Sodic Wastes. Thank you again for the tip and say goodbye. Farewell, child. Is you. Balloon was more fun in the balloon was more fun than that person in it. So here. Sable, is that a badge you've got there? She's okay with it to me. You must have earned it. Well done. I give a bow. Thanks. Well, Sable, if you keep this up, you'll be headed for the mask caster in no time. Try Try to think about going to a mask caster, but it seems impossibly far away. Imagining choosing what I want to be. Imagining choosing what I want to be forever. I know what you're thinking, but don't worry about it. You'll get plenty of badges, and then plenty of badges when you're out there, and once you've got three alike, you can trade it in for a mask. But I don't feel like your first mask is your final choice. The gliding is about freedom and exploration. I suggest you claim as many masks as you wish. Only at your final ceremony will you be asked to choose one. Okay. How will I choose one? You'll have to feel it out. But when you know, you'll know. Now, the turnover now puts butterflies back in my stomach. With all this done, there's only one thing left. Time, isn't it? Time to walk through the face door at the Temple of Rana. There you'll assemble your gliding mask and go. There are things I wish to convey to Jetty here, depths of love and gratitude, and fear and worry and hope. And though I find myself unable to speak any of it in words, I know she understands. Before you leave, child, I got some clothes. I made you these. They're dyed with the traditional Vix and maroon. And I hope provide you with great comfort in the desert. When you leave today, you will no longer be Sable, clan child of the Abexi. You will simply be Sable, and the rest will come. But no matter what you are, no matter where your journey takes you, I will always know you. I will always love you. Aww. And I will see you again. I don't know where my journey will end, but I know where it must begin, and I am ready. So do I take my bike there, or I guess not. Where is this face temple again? Oh, that one. That one's not far. I don't need a bike for that. Oh, that's right, yeah. The tutorial still pops up there. That's cute. Oh, wait. No, oh, yeah, this is. You go here to the face. Press the buttons. Looks like it. So it looks like there's a ramp up on the far side. And a ramp up on that side. That's fine. And then guessing puzzles will get more complicated as I go. There we go. How did I get in here? Oh, probably, yeah, just up the ladders would be probably the smart way to go. Thank you. Sable. This is it. By the time you hear this, we'll have gone. Gliding is a journey that must begin alone. There's a certain nuance lost in transmission, and for that I'm grateful. It will be far too much to hear the cracks in her voice and not run weakly into our arms and stay forever. But I'm ready, and so close. So I close my eyes and listen. But though you go by yourself, you're not without friends, you're not without family, you are not without love. These things you will always carry with you as you do your mask. And I know I'm not supposed to do this, but if I were you, I might go and see Utari. See Utari. Machinist at Burnt Oak Station, and among Season's closest friends, Utari is a good contact to have. Von Scowling, a fine way to get another machinist badge if you're so inclined. Only a suggestion though. As for us, I'll send another message once we've returned to the Ewer. So keep an eye on the post boxes and try not to forget us. She takes a long breath, and I forget that things as easy as breathing could ever exist. Waiting, Sable. Good luck. Much nicer. Very relaxing. All right, let's take a look. Map. So. Might as well exit there. All right. Didn't I buy a map? Or maybe I can't see the map until I'm out of the starting section. Let's see. Through here. There we go.
Feels like everything is more.
I didn't want to do anything until the song ended. Music by Japanese Breakfast, everybody. So it's pretty nice. Oh, okay. Alright, so I thought I'd be able to pick those up. Rock here. Big ol' beetle. I'm not sure why this is getting so framey. I have a dot on. So why did I buy the map? Map of the... It were sold by members of the cartographers. Yeah, so... That's... Oh, that's not the place I'm going. Burnt Oak Station is the place I gotta find. Alright. But I thought, like, the region I was going to was Ewer. Why would I buy a map of the place that I was leaving? Weird. Can I just jump off of this? It's okay. Can I just pull back on the... Yeah, there we go. Okay. Just... Let's roam around for a little bit. Whoop, wobbly. See what's through this little canyon cavern thing, and maybe I'll call it a night after that. Okay, so this looks like a temple. Mysterious, ooh, a mysterious shrine. Alright, well, what time is it now? It's 11. I think, yeah, I'm gonna call it here. So, thanks to anybody who watched, or anybody who's watching this on demand later. Once again, just a reminder, this is a stream in support of St. Baldrick's Childhood Cancer Research Foundation. which is a foundation that funds research for treatment for childhood cancers. They fund research all over the world. They very much are in need of support at all times, because for those of you who don't know, childhood cancer is very deadly and very difficult to treat, and it requires research from a lot of different organizations and a lot of different angles. Like, it's important to have maybe one or two really big efforts that sort of kick down the door on finding new research methods, but you also, before those can be rolled out to everyone, those need to be like confirmed and what's the word I'm looking for, repeated, until we are they can be sure that they're safe for everyone and they are effective for all different kinds of people and different types of treatment and different situations. So it's really not the type of thing you can have just one solution for. You need a lot of people studying the problem. And that's what St. Baldrick's does. They fund a lot of different projects all over the world so that they're all sort of working in tandem, but also checking each other's results and making sure that treatments are effective and stuff like that. So if you'd like to, you can just scan the little QR code that's on the screen right now, and that'll take you to a place to donate. If you're watching on Twitch, you can also go to the About Me section, and there will be a link to donate to St. Baldrick's there. And with that, I'm just going to call it for tonight. I'm not going to do an end card. I'm just going to close out the stream. Thanks, everyone, for watching. I will catch you all later.